The hoist supports the 125 kilogram engine. So this is our hoist and this is our 125 kilogram engine. So 125 kilogram engine is this one. Okay. Determine the force the load creates. Determine the force that this engine load creates in member dB. So that's the member dB. And in member FB, so member FB, this one, which contains the hydraulic cylinder H. So this is actually an hydraulic cylinder H. So what is the force applied at along the member FB and along the member DB? Okay. To solve this problem, it is important to notice and realize that both member BD and member FB are two force members. So realize that members BD and FB are both two force members. Okay, so this makes the solution of such problems, which includes members pin connected to each other, simpler. Okay, so we're gonna write equilibrium equation for member, the specific member GE. So separate that member and to find the force FB for this FB, and write a second free body diagram for this particular vertical member ECE. Okay, so pin that C and pin that E, and includes a force BD, okay, on it. So free body diagram for member GE. Okay, let's start with that. So our member GE is essentially a 3 meter long member, and we have a pin here. We have a pin here at G, and another pin here at E, and there is another pin here at E, and we have this force here, FB. Okay, and that's a 1, 3, and root 10 triangle. We have an applied force at point G here, which is 125 kilograms times 9.81, and that's approximately equal to 1,226 newtons. Okay, and at pin E, we have EY and we have EX here. Okay, so this is our free body diagram, and the lengths are 1 meter here and 2 meters here, right? So let's write down the equilibrium equations here. Okay, the equilibrium equations, we have, if we write moment around moment equation about point E, so moment about point E counterclockwise positive equals zero, so we get this force 1,226 newton times 3 meters minus FFB times 3 over root 10, so that's the vertical component of FFB, times 2 meters, so this vertical component times 2 meters at point A, that causing a moment around point E is equal to zero. So this equation gives us FFB equals 1938 newton, and it's 1.938 kilonewton. Okay, so that's FFB, the force acting on the hydraulic cylinder actually. So for within the member FFB. All right, so as for the force applied at BD, we need to write and draw a new free body diagram. So free body diagram for member EC, the vertical member, okay, EC. Okay, but before that, but let's draw a free body diagram for member EC, and we're going to relate to the previous free body diagram. So the free body diagram for member EC, is this vertical member. So we have a pin here at E, a pin at C. Okay, so this pin at C would be having a horizontal reaction CX and a vertical reaction CY. So at a height of 1 meter from point C, 1 meter here, and from point, so that's pin at D, so that's 2 meters. And at D we have a force that we are trying to find, BD, so this force. So here we have EX and EY, okay, EY, okay. So to find FBD, our strategy would be to write moment equilibrium around point C. So moment equilibrium around point C is equal to zero. So I'm going to write this equation. So for that, I need to find EY and EX, because they will be in the equation of this equation. Okay, so how can you find this? So we could have found, actually, so we will find this EY and EX from free body diagram of member GE. So let's quickly find. So EX is actually equal to FFB times 1 over root 10. Okay, so that's our EX. So FFB, given that FFB is this, so our EX will be 613.125 newton. Okay, so that's EX. And for EY, we're going to write the force equilibrium in the y direction, and that would be EY would be equal to 613.125, so we get the same EX and EY here, newton. So in this equation, we'd be having this vertical force, the vertical component of FFB and EY. Okay, so writing this equilibrium will give us this result. Okay, so that's that, and that's that. So we're going to use these two results here in the moment equation. Okay, so let's write down the moment equation. Actually, for this moment equation, we don't need EY, right? Because that doesn't cause a moment around C. Line of action of EY passes through point C, so that's excluded from that equation. Okay, so we write EX, positive EX times 3. EX is what? EX is 613.125 Newton times 3 meters, okay, minus FBD. So this component of FBD, that's 45 degree, okay? So times sine 45 degree, sine 45 R, okay? Right, that's equal to zero, and there you go. We find FBD will be equal to 2,601.27 Newton or 2.60 kilonewton. Okay, so that's FBD, and this one 1.938 kilonewtons FFB. Okay, so we have found the load, the forces that is created by the load of the engine in member BD, DB, DB here, and member FB here, which includes this hydraulic jack, hydraulic cylinder H. And this concludes the solution of this problem. Thanks for listening.